In vector calculus, a vector field in Rn is a map that assigns to each point in its domain A a vector f. We can easily visualize vector fields, whether in a plane or in a space, by attaching an arrow to each point. When we plot vector fields, we only consider a small sample of points. Otherwise, we will obtain a picture where too many vectors will overlap, making the structure of the field unclear. So, it is better to have, for example, a small regular grid of points. We can also remove the initial points and keep only the arrows. Nowadays, it is incredibly easy to plot and explore vector fields with the help of the computer. In this video, I'm going to show you three of my favorite tools to do this. First, let me show you how to plot vector fields in GeoGebra. So let's go to geogebra.org/3D. This link should open the 3D calculator. Let's plot the simplest 3D vector field, f equal to x, y, and z. In the input, we type the components of the field x, y, and z. Each one of these expressions are multivariable functions. Now let's define a list L using the command sequence. Here the variable k runs from -3 to 3 with an increment of 2, so we obtain a sequence of numbers as a list. Now define the list LP using the command sip 3 times, with the expression ABC within brackets. This expression defines a 3D array of points in R3, where A, B, and C are variables that belong to the list L that we defined previously. Let's define a scale factor just to adjust the length of the vectors if we need it. Finally, we define the vector field as a list BF using the command sip. Here's where we apply the map F. Each component is evaluated at the point P, where P belongs to the list LP previously defined. We also multiply here by the scale factor and hit enter. Unfortunately, GeoGebra gives us a warning or an arrow, as you can see here. The issue is that the list LP is a 3D array. The issue can be solved by using the flatting command so the 3D array becomes a simple list. Notice that now we have plotted the vectors, but the problem is that all the vectors start at the origin. We can adjust the position by introducing the translate command. In this case, we translate the vectors to the point P, which belongs to the list LP. And there it is, a vector field in GeoGebra. You can increase the number of vectors by changing the last parameter in the list L, modify the scale, hide the initial points if you want, and of course you can modify the components to plot a different vector field. Here's the full script. I highly recommend you to try it yourself. You can also plot vector fields in 2D. You just need to go to geogebra.org/calculator to open the calculator suite. The script is even simpler. But if you prefer just to explore vector fields in 2D and 3D, then you can just use these applets that I made a while ago. You just need to change the components. The links are in the description. Another tool that I like to use now is Desmos. Here we're going to use the 3D calculator. So to open it, just go to desmos.com/3D. Again, we are going to explore the simplest vector field. In the input box, we type each one of the components of the vector field. Now we create a list. In Desmos, the syntax to create a list is a little bit different. Here we type square brackets -3... 3, close brackets. This creates a list of numbers from -3 to 3 with an increment of 1. Now let's define a 3D array of points in R3. Here we just type p equal to brackets abc for a, b, and c parameters in the list L. To apply the map f, again, we evaluate each component for each value in p, the 3D array. Notice here in Desmos, using list is a little bit easier. Now let's define our scale factor s. Finally, let's plot the vector field by typing the following expression: S, the scale factor, times vector from point P to the point P plus Q. We can hide all the points and modify the scale to adjust the size of the vectors. And there we have it. Now you can plot and explore vector fields in 3D with Desmos. If you want, you can try to do the 2D version. You just need to make a little change in the previous construction. The last tool I want to cover here is called Math3D. To open it, simply visit math3d.org. The first example displayed is an explicit surface, and the first thing that we have to do is to remove this surface. Now click on the button Add Object and select Vector Field. You should see the following expression, which defines a vector field, and it corresponds to this vector field. Notice that the expression is divided by the square root of x squared plus y squared, which means that it's a common factor. This is equivalent to write each component divided by the square root of x squared plus y squared. So, for example, this expression corresponds to this vector field. Again, we have the square root as a common factor, which is easier to type compared to this long expression. With this tool, we can easily input the components of vector fields that we want to explore. We can modify the range where x, y, and z are defined, and by clicking on the gear button, we can modify a few extra settings. I leave this to you to explore more and have fun. The Math3D tool was developed by Chris Chutsiki and is based on the JavaScript libraries Mathbox and 3.js. The code is open source, and if you enjoy programming, you can explore it on GitHub. That's it, thanks for watching. If you would like to support this channel, you can join me in Patreon. By the way, I recently started a new project on vector calculus. If you're interested in learning more and supporting it, check out the link in the description. Have fun exploring vector fields. Bye bye.